da 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 da.
Okay, so Ben, what does the police academy involve?
It's actually a police training school. But yeah, if you've seen Police Academy, the film, it's basically, it was like that. It's a bunch of coppers, male and female, all with a bit of life experience, some with none, all being put together in a large dormitory for 2 weeks on the first bit, a bit of a gap, and then 17 weeks on the second bit. It was just full of beer, fornication, am I allowed to say that? And a little bit of law, that's all it was. So the first day we got there, we all got introduced, went into a large auditorium. We all sat there, they called us names out, we got put in certain classes, that sort of thing. We got his uniforms given to us, and then we learned things from such as marching, the basic law, the caution, what a pocket notebook was. Started to learn definitions such as theft, to dishonestly appropriate property belonging to another. I know it sounds stupid, but you start to learn bits of definitions. And then basically it was just, don't get arrested, go out, don't do it stupid, and just go out and get drunk. And then when we got back, eat as much as you can. And we always thought for the first 2 weeks, we thought what the police were doing when they were tricking you. And they were basically saying, here's a carte blanche to go do what you want. And we thought they were filming us in the lifts. We thought they were filming us in the dorms. We thought everything was trickery because we'd come down on a Friday, but I think it was Friday Carvery. And it was literally like what you go in a luxury restaurant now, and we says, oh, we can't be eating this. We need to be keeping fit and lean. So there were people just eating little bowls of salad and thinking, no, they're tricking us. They're going to kick you out if you have too much of a Carvery. I know it sounds stupid, but it was true. So all bobbies are there, crisp uniforms, white shirts, ties, brand new boots, and they always used to be bald on end, so they're all like really shiny, you could see your face in. But everyone that were like 6 weeks, 6 months in front of you, first thing they do is go, ooh, new shoes. And you spent like last 3 weeks bullying them and making them really shiny for a drill, and prayed, and they'd come and stand on them and lift. So then you had to go on a drill, Belladrine, you had to go stand there on like that, all crisp uniform, all nice, but with front of your boot, with pattern made from someone else's shoeing. And we had a drill instructor called Sheldrake, right nice bloke, but he just shouted you all the time. He'd get right up to your nose like a proper drilling sergeant from army, and he'd be shouting you, insulting you, and basically trying to get you crumble and see if you're any good at your job. On a night time, we'd all finish work at 5 o'clock, straight upstairs, get changed, have some food down in canteen, and we'll be out in the centre of Wakefield giving it big licks, partying like rock stars and drinking ourselves stupid. We got told on the first night we go out, do not show your warrant card, do not embarrass the force, or do not end up getting arrested because you'll be kicked out straight away. First night we went into Wakefield, we're all stood there, right, respectable. Hello, I'm Ben, nice to meet you. Hello, I'm James. Hello, James. 40 minutes later, everyone's there tipping beer on their head. You know, tops are coming off. Everyone's like, woo, acting like an idiot. And then it got to 11 o'clock and nightclubs had opened. And then first thing, Bobby said, we'll run straight to front of the queue. 30 people queuing with warrant cards in their hand, shouting, I'm a Bobby, let me in, let me in. Out bouncers know exactly who you are. They know that you come straight from police training school because you were just around the corner from Centre Wakefield. And then when you did show your warrant card, you had to sign in with your name. So I'd have to put PC 1965 Pearson. So they'd know who were coming in. We thought, aye, we're being spied on again. They'd want to see your warrant card, and they'd want to see, look, Ben's been in laws. So I just kept on putting Colin Cramporn, who were our chief constable at the time. So it looked like Colin Cramporn had been out boozing every single night a week in Wakefield for like 17 weeks non-stop. There were a lot of things that took place on the corridors because they were mixed arms. There were no segregation. It was just mixed arms. So everyone were coming in smashed at 3 in the morning, having to be up at 8. But canoodling and going into each other's rooms, and they were, so all I can describe it were a Wakefield 1830s holiday. It was proper one of the best times in my life. And then when I did my 2 weeks, they sent me and 5 others down to Ashford in Kent. So we went to Ashford Police Training Centre, and it was built next door to like a massive complex, such as kind of place that has Frankie and Benny's in, Cineworlds, so about 10 restaurants, 4 nightclubs, a load of bars. So we just jump over the fence, downhill, smash till 3 in the morning, you know, pouring it in his ears and his eyeballs and wherever we could drink, we would drink, and make our way back. So as long as we're on, we got told, as long as we're on drill at 8 o'clock in the morning, we'd be fine. So the amount of bobbies that were stood there swaying backwards and forwards, stinking a beer, the old bobbies that would pass out on the drill square. But you've got to admit, this was 2001. All these days are gone now. This doesn't exist anymore. If you join police now, you go through to Cargate, you work at Cargate, and you go home. There's nothing residential. All those days are all gone, but that's how it started. And I remember my uncle telling me, he got in job 6 months before me, and he says, be aware that your life's going to change first day you're all up at Bishop Garth, because it was doing, and it was fantastic. And if I could go back and live those days again, I would do.
You must have had to do a fitness test. What was that like, and what did it involve?
When we first did fitness test, I think we had to get to like 9.4 on bleep test. So if you know what bleep test is, it's running backwards and forwards all the time, but to a controlled bleep, and it gets faster and faster and faster. I think it's only something like, it's either 4.5 or 5.4, it's something, but I'm sure it was 9.4 we had to get to. We had to do strength tests, we had to do jumping tests, a fat test, see how much body your BMI was. I'd fail that now. Look at the size of these moobs. Yeah, if I cough, they sort of like wobble at the moment. What are you laughing for? And it was quite hard at the time. Oh, we had to do press-ups as well. I think we had to do 30 press-ups in a minute. And it doesn't sound a lot, but you had to go down onto someone's... I think it were on your chest or your chin. You had to go down, hold it onto someone's chin or chest, and then push back up. And it were all to a certain time limit. And it were hard. It were, you know what I mean? I were a fit lad at the time. But it were hard for what it was. But now, fitness test is no. I mean, I think they're more scared of people having an heart attack running around fitness room than they are. Also, like, we learn, I think we spent a full week doing empty hand combat skills and arresting techniques, and I think now it's 2.5-3 hours for people to learn. It's also like gone out of window. It's the kind of thing where you probably won't use your cuffs the right lot anymore. You all do a bit of a pile on, and hope someone at back at old courts and helmets have got the cuffs. So that it wasn't us in what I'd panic for, but could I pass it now? Probably not, no.
So you mentioned hand-to-hand combat training and stuff, but what did that involve? What sort of things did they teach you?
We did all sorts from... you did disarmings, you did fighting, blocking techniques, you did kicking, punching. They did an angry man, so there'd be a man fully in, like, protective clothing, and he had a baseball bat or a pickaxe handle, and he'd be in a room smashing room up. And he wasn't holding back. He wasn't pulling any punches. If you swung pickaxe handle, it hit you in the head, it'd seriously hurt you. But you had to go into the room and trap him against wall, disarm him and get some cuffs on him. So there were that. There's times when he did it and they come into the room where you're all sat down, and he'd come in with all still the same gear on, head protectors and everything, but he'd have a knife in his hand. So you had to sort of like challenge him and then try and lock him up, and if not, take him down, give him a bit of a shoo-in. But always an instructor, you know, 4 weeks out from retirement, didn't want to like hurt himself, but you always like threw him to the floor and damaged his hip, so to speak. But yeah, that were a good experience with that. But the years it's gone on in the force, it's got lighter and lighter and lighter. And I seem to think they don't really want you to do put hands on people the right lot anymore, unless you really, really have to. But I personally think that's not the way you should be policing. I think you should be policing, and if people are breaking law, they need gripping hold of, because there's too many people now saying, I'm going to sue you. So, but that's only my view.
Was there people that you went through training with that wouldn't have passed?
Oh, yeah, there were loads. I think someone said to us at one point, I can't remember the exact numbers, but I think there were 50 that got in our intake. But someone said, 25,000 people have applied, only 8,000 have sent their application back. Only 4,000 of that has been, you might have said you've got to do it in black ink. Only 4,000 have been done in black ink. And then only 2,000 of them have passed the actual, how can I put it, behind the scenes checks and being eligible to come into police. And then it whittles it down, and then they realise that you're 50, so they say, out of all these people that have sent off an application, you're the last 50. And you sat there with them and all, and it's like, yeah, it's brilliant. But there were people, one of the people in Ashford in Kent, we all had, there was a big gym, and a lot of people remember this. One lad got in as a bobby. ended up having a wrestle around with someone, pulled a dart out, a dartboard, and put it to someone's eye in an headlock. So I ended up stabbing him in the eye with it. And he said, "This is a bobby. What are you doing?" One person got locked up drinking and driving in the first couple of weeks, got kicked out. One person got kicked out for fighting. One person just struggled with a fitness test, and I think they ended up getting thrown out. So, yeah, you've still got to make a grade, and sometimes people do slip through the net and get in, but they're soon whittled out. Because, like I said, it's a massive, massive culture shock. It's not something where once you're in front door, you're in, and you can get away with doing whatever you can't, because every minute of every day, then in 2001, everything you did was scrutinised. You had to be in your class at a certain time. If you got to your class and you were hung over and stunk a beer, was fine, but you had to be in your class. You had to pass your exams, you had to pass your march, and you had to learn to march. Or you got, like, I can't remember if you got kicked off, but you got a massive bollocking. They wouldn't stand for it. They'd make you get there half an hour before everyone's having a meal. They'd make you be out on drill square learning how to march. It were proper like military, but on the fun side, it were also more fun than what you'd expect. Probably like you said, in what it were like an army, you know, an army barracks and things like that. You're working hard in daytime, so you're going to work hard playing.
They are forced to go into the police academy. It's either that or jail. Did you ever get anything like that in real life?
No, it were. Back then, again, like I said, in 2001, to join the police were a massive, massive kudos thing. It were a brilliant job, a well-paid job, great pension, this sort of thing. Nothing to how it is now, but no, you were there because you wanted to be there. But let's be honest, there's people there from wrong end of tracks that have managed to get through. But they were all soon whittled out. But yeah, there were no tackle barriers and no eye towers when I joined, unfortunately. This is my new book, Quarter Tango 2-3. It's available from Amazon now, and click the link below if you want one. Thank you.